Hello dear students, welcome to our botany class. So in today's botany class, we are going to discuss one new topic, that is about the sexual reproduction in Polysiphonia. First let us see the identification characters or the comments. The female sex organs are called carpogonia, which are formed on the trichoblasts, which are present on female gametophyte. A flask-shaped carpogonium develops at the apex of 4 to 5-celled carpogonial filament or procarp. One of the pericentral cells of adaxial surface functions as supporting cell. This supporting cell divides transversely to form 4 to 5-celled slightly curved carpogonial filaments. The terminal cell of carpogonial filament, it functions as carpogonial mother cell, which eventually forms carpogonium. The basal swollen part of carpogonium has egg and appears narrow elongated neck, which is called as trichozyne. The supporting cell cuts off into the basal sterile, initial and lateral sterile initial. Male gametes of Polysiphonia are non-motile, carried by wind currents to the long receptive trichozyne. The nucleus of spermatium, it passes down the trichozyne and fuses with the egg to form zygote. So these are the identification characters of Polysiphonia. Now let us see the post-fertilization changes that occur in this Polysiphonia. The basal and lateral sterile initials divide to form 2 to 4 celled sterile filaments and 4 to 10 celled lateral sterile filaments. And the supporting cell divides transversely to form an auxiliary cell at its upper end. A tubular connection is established between an auxiliary cell and carpogonium base. And the diploid zygote, it divides mitotically into two daughter nuclei. One nuclei passes into auxiliary cell through tubular connection. And the auxiliary cell, the supporting cell, and sterile filaments, they fuse together to form an irregular shaped large placental cell. The diploid nucleus of auxiliary cell divides mitotically into several nuclei. From the upper side of the placental cell, several protuberances develop into which diploid nuclei migrates. These protuberances cuts off from the placental cells and functions as gonemoblast filaments. The terminal cell of each gonemoblast filament, it becomes swollen and develops into a pear-shaped carposporangium. The protoplast of carposporangium develops into single diploid carpospore, and the carposporangium along with the gonemoblast filaments, they get enclosed within a sheath of vegetative filaments and they form as urn-shaped body called cystocarp or carposporophyte. So the opening of cystocarp is also called as osteole. So carpospores are liberated through osteole, carried by water currents, and on germination they form a diploid sexual thallus, that is tetrasporophyte. In this way, these are the post-fertilization changes that we can observe in this Polysiphonia. Thank you.